He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, let's do some practice regarding enthalpy of combustion. So the question asks, how much heat is released upon the combustion of 1.00 liters of isooctane? And that has the formula C8H18. Now, in order to answer this question, we will need to know that the density of isooctane is 0.692 grams per milliliter. And we also need to know that the delta H of combustion for isooctane is negative 5,461 kilojoules per mole. So this is all the data you need. Go ahead and give this a try. So let's start out with our 1.00 liters of isooctane. What are we going to do first? Well, we know we're going to do some kind of stoichiometry, so we're going to want to try to get to moles. So how do we do this? Well, we've got liters, and our density was in grams per milliliter, so we're going to need milliliters. So let's just convert this into milliliters first. We've got 1.00 liters times 1,000, and since we can only have 3 sig figs, that is going to be 1.00 times 10 to the 3 milliliters. Now, as we said, we have that density, so we can convert to grams. 1.00 times 10 to the 3 milliliters times 0.692 grams per milliliter. Milliliters will cancel, and we'll get 692 grams. So now that we have a mass of isooctane, we want to use that mass to get moles, because that way we can use the delta H of combustion that we were given. So 692 grams times 1 mole over 114 grams, that's what we get just by adding up all the carbon and hydrogen atoms, that is going to give us 6.07 moles. So we have 6.07 moles of isooctane in that 1 liter of isooctane. And then lastly, we can use our thermochemical data. We can do 6.07 moles times negative 5,461 kilojoules that are released for every mole of isooctane. And we get negative 3.31 times 10 to the 4 kilojoules. That is how much energy is associated with the combustion of 1 liter of isooctane.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.